I didn't have to hang off, I'm gonna just sit back here with my wife and my daughters and be celebrating and sit right along with you. We're just so excited about Melissa and Jonathan and this wonderful service and what these communities. I want to say one other thing, that is that Basil Watson, pastor of the First Wesleyan Church, service today, a wonderful brother and colleague of the Lord, and do a fantastic job. If you're looking for a church, he's got a good church. If you're looking for another church that's good as well, that is a loving, wonderful family that loves your family. Enjoy the service.
I one way of this man, this woman, Napoleon matrimony, which is an honorable state, institute of God, signifying, in other words, the mystical union which exists between Christ and his church. This holy state Christ adorned, unified with his presence in Cana, Galilee, and the Apostle Paul commended as honorable among all men. It is therefore not to be entered in unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. I require and charge you both, as you stand here in the presence of God, to remember that love and loyalty to the Lord will avail as the foundation of a happy and enduring home. No other human ties are more tender, no other vows more sacred than those and these you're now renewing. If you summon these oaths to Solomon and to be faithfully kept, and if steadfastly endeavor to do the will of God, you will have joy and love, and you will establish a home and have peace. Go get this one.
Thank you.
I am deeply honored this afternoon to be here to be the sheriff, Jonathan Melissa, in the ceremony. And when they called me and asked if I would do this, I said, well, I need something. Not getting anything bad, but I have gone to the Christian school and have done chapel there many times, and bringing devotions and talking to the kids in chapel because I love young people. And just going in there and being able to preach the gospel, they heard something and it stuck with them, so they wanted me to come and share with them. And it's been a privilege. My wife and I have sat down with them, we've counseled with them, and encouraged them. And what I want to say to you, Jonathan, is that the Bible says, unless the Lord build a house, we have to build it labor in vain. And this is a beautiful celebration this evening. Over the years, one of the things that I've seen sometimes that happens in church is that folks get married in the church, but they don't take the Lord in the church with them. But both of you are professing faith in Jesus Christ, and that's the beauty of this afternoon, because unless he is the center of what you're building, then you can't make it on your own. And so I am truly blessed to see two young people who love Jesus Christ and who are making a commitment to stay together for a lifetime. And it's a great honor for me. And so I was thinking about some of the things that we talk about in counseling. You know, we were talking last night, we were laughing. Without love, she reacts disrespectfully. Without respect, he reacts without love. And we were talking about the crazy cycles that couples get on. How do you get off the crazy cycle? By learning how to decipher, decode what she's saying. We talk about it the other evening, we laugh a little bit again. She says, I have nothing to wear. It means she has nothing new. Distinct, things different than blue, right? He says, I have nothing to wear. And somebody says, you mean she didn't do the laundry either? Right? You know what I mean? So think and blue, think different. So we walk through some of those things in counseling. We talk about building an enduring home. And one of the things I want to share with Jonathan and Melissa is the importance of praying for each other. The couple that prays together stays together. The couple that prays together will love each other for a lifetime. Because conflict will come, but not all conflict is bad. Because after conflict, it's mental. It's a good thing. So not all conflict is bad, right? And if you guys will learn that, to pray for one another, to encourage each other more, you'll have a wonderful and enduring home. Probably then, last, Mr. Chief, was telling me how, since you were a little girl, and you became a Christian.